everyone, welcome to Morning English. This is January.
Hello, everybody. This is Nora. 欢迎大家收听早安英文。
Nora, do you have any plan for the upcoming weekend? 周末有什么安排吗
？Yeah, I'll go see a live show.
Let me guess, a rock band live show?
No, actually, it's a hip hop show.
Hip hop? I never knew you were into hip hop. 我只知道你喜欢摇滚，但是没有想到你居然还喜欢嘻哈。
Yay, 我其实还挺喜欢 hip hop 的。
So, Nora, who is your favorite rapper?
那当然是我们的入党积极分子 Cardi B 啦。
哎，入党积极分子，这是一个什么梗吗？
Well, this is because of her praising China's response to the outbreak and calling out xenophobia against Chinese people in the US.
哦，就是因为 Cardi B 之前在直播当中盛赞中国的防疫成果。
没错。
同时呢，他还强烈反对美国民众对于华人的歧视，所以被中国网友盛赞为入党积极分子。
对对，而且他还特别开心自己可以登上中国的新闻，还发推特炫耀。发推特炫耀的时候呢，还时不时的带上一个五星红旗。
Yeah, she celebrated her newfound stardom in Chinese social media. She was so happy that she made it in the Chinese news.
嗯，那我们今天就一起来聊一聊这位中国人的老朋友 Cardi B。
今天呢，给大家送个超棒的福利，早安英文会员课程的七天免费体验权限，只有十个名额哦。同时呢，大家也可以加入早安英文的 Telegram 社群，来群里和我们一起交流。社群地址和七天会员的免费领取链接都放在评论区了，欢迎你来。
So, I actually saw some videos of Cardi B. She's really funny and very straightforward.
是的 ,straight 意思就是直啊 ,forward 就是向前的。So, straightforward 就是说这个人非常的耿直。
Yeah, Cardi B has slammed trolls who have criticized her for going under the knife. 网上有很多喷子就批评她做过整容手术，然后她就直接拍视频来回击。
对，那我们说的这种网络喷子啊，就可以用到这个单词 troll， 也可以称他们为 internet trolls。
对，也就是键盘侠。那呛声回击键盘侠，我们就可以用到一个动词，叫做 slam。这个单词的本意呢，就是啪嗒一下，关闭的意思。比如说摔门就是 slam the door.
Yeah, so Cardi B slammed trolls because they criticized her for going under the knife.
Go under the knife 也是一个非常地道的表达。Knife 是刀的意思。
嗯，
那么在这里它是指的手术刀，所以 go under the knife 手术刀之下，也就是指的做手术。
对，所以我们以后说要做整容手术啊，除了说 have a plastic surgery， 还可以说 go under the knife。So Jane, would you go under the knife?
Hell no.
So how did Cardi B hit out at those trolls?
Well, she said, am I bugging? Women talk about uplifting each other, but are we really uplifting each other?
Uplift, 意思就是抬起的意思啊。这里指的是支持振作起来。其实她就是在质问那些黑子们。女性总是说要相互的扶持对方啊，但是这种情况下我们真的算是相互扶持相互帮助的吗？
Yeah, so we can see that she's very outspoken.
Exactly. 那卡老师啊，她除了会拍一些视频的小品，她的业务能力啊也是非常的强的。
Cardi was the first solo female artist to win Best Rap Album at Grammy Awards.
对，她是首位获得格莱美最佳说唱专辑奖的女 rapper。She definitely made history, and recently she was named Billboard's 2020 Woman of the Year.
嗯，而且啊，她从来不忌讳谈论自己的过去。At 19, Cardi B started working as a stripper.
Strip 有脱衣服的意思，那么
stripper 指的就是脱衣舞女，所以可以看出来她的出身其实并不是很好。
Yeah, she said she did it to escape an abusive relationship and make money to go to university.
虽然最后她还是辍学了，但是她经常告诫女孩们要接受良好的教育，否则就会像自己一样就要去。
虽然说她的经历比较歪曲，但是感觉她的三观还是非常正的。
嗯。
So in 2 years, she's gone from an exotic dancer to making history at the Grammys.
That's right. 虽然卡老师事业上顺风顺水啊，但是感情上好像不是那么的顺利。
What happened?
Well, she has filed for divorce from her fellow rapper husband, Offset.
对，前段时间她就正式向法院提出申请，爆出她要和老公 Offset 离婚的惊天消息。
对， 那 divorce 就是指的离婚，向法院申请提出离婚呢，这里用到了一个词叫做 file for。 file 做名词的时候呢，就是文件，做动词呢，表提出申请。
Yeah, and Cardi described their marriage as irretrievably broken, 就是说他们的婚姻是不可挽回的。
Yeah, because Cardi B was tired of her husband Offset's non-stop cheating and sexting other women. It has been a problem in their relationship from the very beginning, and she just couldn't take it anymore.
Non-stop cheating, 就说明 Offset 是一个出轨的惯犯了。
是的，而且从一开始 Offset 就在出轨，那 Cardi B 呢也忍受不了了。Actually, she cheated throughout their entire relationship.
这也太渣了吧。所以感觉网友们对 Cardi B 要离婚的消息感觉到非常的开心啊。
我很开心。
因为终于要甩掉渣男了。
对，所以有网友就评论说 This is a strong woman making a decision to better her life.
一个坚强的女人决定要让她的生活变得更好。我们要注意这句话中 better 这个单词的用法。Better 我们一般比较常见的用法是做形容词，表示更好的。 For example, a better job, a better car. 但是在这里呢，它是做了动词，表示提高、改进、改善。
对，但 Cardi B 的决心好像并不是那么的坚定。你知道，为了复合 ，Offset 也是使出了各种招数啊。他在 Instagram 上面呢，就讲了一篇声泪俱下的小作文，来向卡老师道歉。
What did he say?
Well, Offset was like,I was partaking in activity that I shouldn't be taking in, and I apologize for breaking your heart, breaking our promise, breaking God's promise, and being a selfish, messed up husband.
Well, he's right about one thing, for being selfish and messed up.
你知道我刚刚念出来那一段，我都觉得我自己有一点渣。Well, and he's been very manipulative.他在卡老师参加音乐节的时候啊，还甚至跑到舞台上再次道歉，是不是特别的厚脸皮？
是的。
那其实这种渣男套路啊，已经见怪不怪了嘛。但是卡老师就还是很吃这一套。
所以我感觉，别看卡老师在生活当中是那种御姐范，但是可能他在恋爱当中就是那种小女生的心态，恋爱脑。
Yeah, she did.
So don't tell me she changed her mind again.
Well, yes, she called off her divorce and filed to dismiss separation from Offset.
那么在这个句子当中呢 call off 和 dismiss 都是表示取消。Call off her divorce and dismiss separation 就是表示放弃离婚，选择复合。
You know, I think Offset is definitely gonna cheat again.
Yeah, I bet. But Cardi B definitely deserves better.
对，就让我想起了一首歌啊。泰勒不是有首歌是 Haters are gonna hey, 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 hey. 我觉得这地方应该改成
Cheaters gonna cheat, cheat, cheat.
那总之呢，我还是希望凯老师赶紧抽身，独自美丽吧。But anyway, it's her own decision.
Right, 我们吃了这么久的瓜，我们节目呢也要到尾声了。
That's all for today's podcast. This is Nora. Thanks for listening.
This is Jen. See you next time. Bye.
今天的节目就到这里了，大家别忘了去评论区领取我们的福利，早安英文会员课程的7天免费试听名额，只有10个，先到先得。最后，大家如果想加入我们的听众群，也可以在评论区置顶找到我们的 Telegram 社群地址，欢迎你来玩。
This podcast is from Morning English.
学口语。就来早安英文。